The kids never reveal how they're really feeling. I'm in the mood for a little bit of Birch. Delicious. Story about the chances of a woman over 35 getting married, and apparently they ain't too damn good. Statistics say you have a better chance of going to Europe and getting killed by a terrorist. Well, needless to say, I wasn't too damn happy to get this news. All right, marriage has never been a priority to me, but you know what? I would like my options left open. Excuse me, what girl doesn't? I was trying to figure out who was out there making us women feel shitty about ourselves again. I wondered what I should be when I grew up. I found myself reminiscing about the woman I could have been. You see, originally it was my plan to move to San Francisco and become an executive secretary. The day I arrive, my furniture is already there. My chintz fold-out couch looks like $1 million in my studio apartment. As do my split bamboo curtains from Pier 1 Imports. I get up early my first day on the job and choose something by Courage to wear. I fix a light breakfast, a slice of whole wheat toast, cottage cheese with pineapple pieces, a cup of decaf and cinnamon. I arrive at work, steno pad in hand, 3 sharpened pencils. My boss is rattling off dictation. My shorthand, perfection. He looks up and says, "Are you finished yet?" I said, "I was finished before I began." I notice his left hand, no wedding ring. I'm beginning to like this man. As I walk down the hallway to get him his coffee black, hold the cream, I'd love to. I stay late to impress him, but I'm of San Francisco, through my door, removing my boots, giving my low back a full range of motion, as recommended by Cosmopolitan magazine. I feel confident as I step into my bath, remembering I've already applied my Rubbermaid daisies. I soak for hours in Calgon bouquet, with cool cucumber slices on my eyes. I shampoo my hair with herbal essence shampoo. I smell like a garden of earthly delights. I step out carefully, grabbing my field crest, 100% cotton oversized towel, rubbing myself down vigorously, bringing much needed blood to the surface of the skin. I glow as I splash on love's fresh lemon. I choose to wear my hair up and put in some baby's breath. I look really pretty. There's a knock on the door. It's the first day on the job and the first day with the boss. And he takes me on a tour of San Francisco I never dreamed possible. We begin on Lombard Street, the crookedest street in the world, and I never felt straighter. Down to Ghirardelli Square, he buys me a giant chocolate kiss. What not? Over to Fisherman's Wharf, we share a shrimp louis. And to top the evening off, the most incredible drag show I've ever seen at Pinocchio's. We walk home together, shyly, hand in hand, cutting 2 imposing figures through the fog. I hesitate briefly before inviting him in for a nightcap. We stare, looking out over the view of the bay. He wraps his arms around me from behind, caressing my huge breasts. We fall dramatically backwards into my couch bed, which is remarkably open. And as I lean over to turn off the lamp and the modular furniture fades into the mist, I realize one thing. I'll never be as lipstick